Welcome everyone. Today I'm doing a little interview with an amazing woman I've met on LinkedIn, Tasia Valenta. Tasia is a Emmy Award winning voiceover artist. She is a TEDx speaker and she teaches confidence to many people by giving great voice. Welcome, Tasia.
Thank you so much, Tizia. It's wonderful to be with you. And I love that we are giving great voice to each other right now.
Oh, definitely. Absolutely. So can you tell us a little bit about what you do by giving great voice to people? I watched your TEDx speech and you talked about becoming a voiceover artist in your own life. So please tell us, how can you help us with that?
Sure. So from my background of being an actress and a voiceover actor and playing thousands of roles and literally giving great voice, which I consider the act of being able to move, touch, and impact using our voice. So that's what I've been doing for all my life. And I realized that those same skills that allowed me to play thousands of roles as mothers and wives and CEOs and lawyers and professionals, and as well as, you know, Jedis and poisonous poison ivy, you know, wonderful characters, also allow me to use my voice in my real life roles much more successfully, because I understand the principles of playing a role well, the aspirational qualities. And so I realized that I could teach the same skills that have helped me be successful in my communication in my life, as well as my career, and teach this to everyone so that they can feel more powerful, more charismatic, more compassionate, more conscious in their communication. And ultimately, it comes down to our communication, our human communication, more than our digital and our emails and our Snapchats. It's the conversations that we have with ourselves, with each other, that ultimately is the success of our lives. So I've taken this platform to give great voice and I made it into a TEDx. And now I coach and teach both workshops and privately to help people feel more confident in their communication.
That's so amazing. And you touched on a really interesting subject right there, because we are now so much online and we are messaging each other, texting each other. And I think sometimes we are forgetting to speak to each other. But before we go into that, first I want to know, I think it all starts with our inner voice, right? It's how we speak to ourselves,
yes,
which is so important. How can you elaborate on that by giving great voice?
Sure. And I know that you're so much about mindset and you're always teaching that. And I love what you share. And so I just bring a little bit of the novel perspective of taking the thoughts that are 60 to 70,000 thoughts a day. And, you know, studies have shown that 80% of those thoughts are negative thoughts from the day before and the year before and the year before. And we don't even realize that they're running us. And so to give great voice is the act of taking those thoughts and rewiring, re-updating the software, as I like to say, by using our voices to affirm ourselves. In other words, so much of the time we're in our heads and a lot of the thoughts are thinking, I'm unworthy, I'm not enough, imposter syndrome. And so to give great voices to ourselves is literally to re-motivate ourselves and say, no, I am limitless. I am powerful. I am worthy. I liken it to the metaphor of learning to speak the language of self-empowerment, self-love. And it's a foreign language to most people. Somehow we are wired that it's cocky or arrogant to say kind things to ourselves, which I don't know where that came from. But my thought is, no, you know, let's use our own voices. The most important voice we will ever hear is our own. And so we can say and affirm and start wondering, noticing that that's a thought, but does that serve my role? Does that support all these dreams of these conscious desires that I have? And if it doesn't, how can I re-update that software? So I not only say affirmations with, you know, channeling your inner superhero with conviction and confidence consistently. I love the C's because it does feel awkward at first, but just so learning a language is awkward, right? We were like, when you speak how many languages, right? It's uncomfortable. Right. But if you do it consistently, all of a sudden you can find the restaurant and get to the bathroom. And then one day you're fluent. Same with the language of self-empowerment. You must start with affirmations and consistently. And I even have an affirmation meditation app that's completely free to help do that, because it's, again, it's a tool. It's a tool just like learning it. So speaking to ourselves first and foremost and starting to re-update the software because we wouldn't use a computer that's a year old without a software update. And we're mostly running on hard drives that are 40 years old, right? The programming doesn't work well.
That's so true.
That's the most important person, to give great voice, fill ourselves up, motivate and inspire ourselves to succeed and overcome all the daily challenges that we face. And then we have so much more bandwidth to give great voice to others.
Yeah, no, couldn't agree more. And interesting that you talked about updating our own drive, so to speak, because I think negative thoughts, we all have those, you know, but they can become like a habit. And this is what you need to change. And so the updating part is really interesting. If you feed yourself with the thoughts that you do need and the voice that is serving you, then you can start updating that. And I think that will take some time before, you get rid of those old habits.
Yes. But if you do it, the point is to give permission to yourself and to recognize this, that you have to replace a habit with a habit, right? So you have a habit of negative thoughts. So how can we replace that with positive ones? Let's use our own voice. Let's start using affirmations. This is Brian Tracy. I didn't come up with the idea. I just recognized that it's something that I can really help people to use their voices powerfully, and not just an affirmation doesn't work when you say it. I love myself. I believe in myself. I am worthy. That doesn't work. That's just the word. You have to say it with conviction. You have to say it with passion. You have to fake it till you make it. Or as Amy Cuddy said in her famous TED talk, fake it till you become it. Yes. Act as if and you will become.
And keep repeating it until you actually feel it.
Right. And you can fake it. You can use a power pose. You know, you can use biology to hack it. You can channel your inner superhero. There's the voiceover actor in your own life. You know, if I were to stand here with this position, right? This is the Wonder Woman. My name is Tasia Valenza. It's a pleasure to be with you, right? I'm channeling my inner Wonder Woman. Now, if I said, my name is Tasia Valenza. It's a pleasure to be with you. This would be incongruent, right? So channel. Borrow from your favorite superhero. Why do we love superheroes? Because they're powerful and they're confident and we believe them. So stand in the mirror, do your power pose and say your affirmation. Today is an incredible day. This meeting is going well. I'm capable. All the things that you want to say, and recognize that you have the power to override those thoughts. You are not your thoughts. We are not our thoughts. We often think we are. We just fall down the rabbit hole.
That's that inner voice, right? And this is something also I didn't come up with myself. Someone has taught me that too. When you try something new, per definition, usually it's uncomfortable. And then comes that little voice in your head that says, no, don't go there. Just stay on the couch, watch Netflix, eat donuts. Don't go try that new thing. Don't apply for that job, right? But what do you want to do? Who is in control here? Is that little voice, or are you in control?
Right. And the thing is exactly what you say. So that you must be the big voice that overrides the little voice. The little voice gets to stay in your head. You, instead of trying to do a voice to voice, because the old ones are much more locked in, they're stronger. If you think of it as a superhero, there's the evil villain, the part of you that wants you not. And also actually, it's also your defense mechanism to keep you safe.
Absolutely.
So if we understand this is keeping me safe because it's scary to go do, so this is my biology. But hey, I'm going to put this to rest. I'm going to use my voice and say, I can do this. I am capable. I'm going to. You can be, I call it being your own confidence coach, your own coach that you would pay for. We all need coaches. But we can start with ourselves and also your own compassionate companion. Because sometimes we just need to put our hands on our hearts and say, this is scary, but we're going to do this.
Just we're going to do it anyway because we want to move forward.
Exactly. Exactly. But we can use our voice to externalize it and get it out of our heads. Because in our heads is where I feel like we'll let those old thoughts override because they've been there a lot longer.
Yeah, definitely. And so to come back on the text part, right? So in your TEDx talk, you spoke about that using your voice to get across a message is so much more powerful. You can put so much more power in that, more compassion in that, instead of just sending a little text.
And trying to get the emojis all in there too.
Right.
text is wonderful for the head, for facts, for getting out information. But my thought is once it becomes an emotional component, something that's supposed to evoke emotion, the voice is 1,000 times greater connection. I'll give you an example that every time I leave a LinkedIn message with my voice, not only do I get a surprise joy for the most part of a delight of like, oh, most people don't even know you can do that. The other is they feel so delighted that I took the time to lend my voice and to create a warm tone that was much more inviting. And a lot of times people say, I'm going to start doing that as well. So
it
jumps 10 steps in the digital communication if you are trying to create a relationship. And it's also something that gives permission for other people to do it. So I think it's a win-win.
Oh, absolutely. And speaking of the LinkedIn messaging, I do get a lot of messages. And I do remember those people who sent me that voice message. And it's so much more personal. You know, it's like also the difference between getting a personal handwritten card from someone or just a flat text.
Correct.
And then just that little personal touch, even on a card or in a voice message, that's just, that makes it so much more, you know, you can feel the intention from the person, right?
That's why I always talk about the remarkable power of tone and intention when we combine them. I mean, I watch you in your videos and I've been so inspired by you when you're sharing all about your passions to help people. And it instantly connects me to you, because I hear your sincerity. I see your beautiful smile. It comes through the voice. And that is something that we can all be more aware of. One of the easiest tips I can give to people is to really be conscious of a warm smile, a warm, inviting tone. Because so often we don't realize that we might be just saying, hello, hello. But they did a study, Vanessa Edwards, who's a scientist who studies people, that one word, hello, said with a smile, hello, versus sad, hello, versus angry, hello, versus a power pose, hello. That person was deemed, just the voice, just the one word, 70% more likable.
Yeah.
So not only are you giving warmth when you smile with a warm tone and releasing your own feel-good hormones like dopamine and oxytocin, because we do when we smile, but you are being perceived as warmer, more inviting, more trustworthy. And that is good for all relationships, including business.
Yes, no, couldn't agree more. And so tell me, Tasia, you also developed an app, right?
Yes.
Tell us about that.
So it's a free affirmation. It's a guided affirmation meditation app that, again, you know, the universe collided and I was able to co-found. And it's called Haven Guided Affirmations. And I really found out, because I had used affirmations, but when I had to co-write it, I really dived deep into what affirmations are. And I realized again how powerful they can be, especially in a state of relaxation and hypnosis. You know, Bruce Lipton is a famous epigeneticist who's well known in terms of wiring the brain. And he talks about how we can basically rehypnotize ourselves when we're in a state of relaxation and repetition. So what is an affirmation meditation app? Relaxation and repetition. So it's broken down into different masteries, confidence, health, wealth, depression support, 10 minutes of me in your ears, soothing, lovely tone. And then practicing, again, affirmations that you can practice with me and then make that something that can help you have a new habit, which is that new habit of I am, I have, I believe, but done in a way that when maybe you're more receptive, because, you know, when you are first learning this language, it's like, no, you're not. You know, it's like, I love myself. No, you don't. But if when you're relaxed and you have that nice breath work, you can receive the information and maybe you'll be more willing. And also it's just a 10-minute habit that you can introduce at any moment. You're having a little anxiety, you're feeling your heart palpitate, the negative thoughts, because again, we're all going through so much right now. And
oh, we are, definitely.
I call it a Be Kind to Our Mind app, and who can't use a little bit more of that every day?
Oh, I think we all do. And I have several apps actually that I, you know, try, but I'm definitely going to try your app. And after I make a post for this interview, then we're going to put the link in and then people can you know, download your app and find it in the Play Store or Apple Store.
Yeah, it's completely free. There's no strings. Yeah. It's just something that I love to do as a tool to support people's minds and hearts and feelings. And I as you were saying, you know, it's for all ages of, and I think young people right now are really struggling too. It's a wonderful way to learn this language early, because again, most of us don't speak so kindly to ourselves freely. And so I would love to get it to more teenagers to start helping support their mental health, because mental health right now is we're really struggling, and I feel we all need lifts and boosts right now. And this is just my way of extending that and supporting people's love and kindness for themselves, and then to start this practice of kindness. And also guided meditation can be really helpful for people that don't. I myself have a monkey mind. I recognize that. And I love a beautiful guided meditation, because it helps me to tap into a voice. And again, I really try to bring a very lovely, soothing tone, so that I can listen to the words and download them, as opposed to some meditations and are just quieting the mind. And I have a hard time myself with that. So I love guided meditation. And it's a great entry point into meditation for those that are seeking it out, but feel like they don't do it well because they can't turn off their brains.
Yeah, no, that definitely takes some practice. I'm for sure going to try it out, and maybe even listen with my kids to it. Because I think, you know, the younger you learn these types of skills, the better.
Absolutely.
Yes, and be kind to your mind. I love that, and that's what we all need these days. Yes. So, thank you so much for sharing what you do with us. And how can people reach you best if you want to contact you for your program or for coaching?
Sure. So of course I'm on LinkedIn. That's how we met. And you can leave a digital message or a voice message if you want to practice Give Great Voice. And I have my website, Give Great Voice, as well. And if you're interested in the voiceover side of me, you know, to see what I've done, I have Tasia Valenza. So I'm on all social, but I guess for our purposes, LinkedIn messaging is just the easiest way. And I would love to help coach and do workshops to support people to learn this fun way to gain more confidence and more captivating communication. And that's why I really try to approach it, to make it fun, because I think we all are very intrigued with voiceover artists, and it's a wonderful way to approach public speaking, as it were, but really from a lens of fun and joy.
Oh, absolutely. I think it's just so wonderful what you do, and you can use this in so many aspects of your life, both personally and professionally. So I would encourage all of you to connect to Tasia, connect to her on LinkedIn, and yes, leave a Give Great Voice message to her if you want to know more and get some coaching by her. Thank you so much, Tasia, for this wonderful interview. And let's all follow Tasia. Thank you.
I'm grateful. Thank you. And you give great voices. It's my highest compliment that I can say. You always bring such kindness and warmth and intention whenever you speak. And I'm a great admirer of yours, which is why we've connected. So thank you, Tizia.
Thank you so much, Tasia. Thank you for being here. Okay, I'll see you all next time. Bye.